In my presentations, I always have to start with a disclaimer. Any political views that I say in this presentation are representative of my views and not the company where I work. We are not involved in politics. However, I am very interested in politics, and I do not see a separation between our political structures, our cultural environment, and then the design that we do. So I see all of that as one big package. The Lebanese Civil War, this is how I grew up, unfortunately. For my generation, and this is the kind of thing that is at the heart of all of this because of the trouble in the region, and it's something to keep in mind when we look at the region. We really need to understand the history and what is making it what it is. But it's also interesting to look into the homes and see how people live. And there's so many different ways that people are living in the different parts of the Middle East. And Lebanon is very relatively free press. We have more freedom to say what we want to say and to disagree. The others have been having a lot of trouble in the last 2 years, but hopefully we'll make it through. But this is sort of like a third of my presentation talking about culture and the situation there. But it's impossible to design for me without having an understanding of where my work is going to be seen as part of the visual culture. So the entire region, when we talk about it, you have people filled with the most beautiful souls. This is not what you get to see on TV, unfortunately, when Arabs are being depicted. You have your typical everyday people. We have the beauty of architecture. We have a beauty in patterns, the arabesques that we have. And we are most fortunate to have a beauty of letters. So when we talk about Arabic, and this is where my fascination is lies, and this is with the beauty of the letter forms and the gorgeousness of the different calligraphic styles that we have. And we have a disconnect between our calligraphic traditions and our typographic traditions for reasons that I can't really get into now because it's a very, very long story. But we have a question. We have an amazing, amazing calligraphic tradition that is very rich and varied, often very complex and very dynamic. And at the same time, we have very poor typographic forms, up until recently at least. And the question becomes, when you are free of technological constraints, as we are now, would you go back to the complex forms, or would you still stay with the simpler versions? When we are designing for Arabic, we have the choice to go from simple to more complex. And that is a question that we need to see. So what is an Arabic typeface? What is modern Arabic typography? Do we go back to the calligraphic styles that we had 200 years ago? Or do we look at how we live today, and then we see what is appropriate? What is the function of a typeface? Where is it going to be used? What sort of landscape is it being used in? And then see what we want to design. And that's sort of my area of preference. This is quite complex when it comes to putting letters together, because you have all of these dynamic forms coming in and forming very complex shapes. So part of the PhD was basically to look at the effect of that. If we are able to design in simple styles and then in complex styles, then how do we make a choice? You can make a good design in both directions. So how do you make the choice? And for me, it was important to see which one is more legible, which one do we recommend? So the gray is the simplified, the black is the dynamic, which is the more complex, and so the gray is faster to read. And it's always good to bring a little bit of science into design so that they can inform our decisions. And it's not just a subjective view, but rather scientific research, which you can use to back up your design instincts. The project that I worked on for An-Nahar newspaper in Beirut, this is the largest daily newspaper in the country. Of everything that I've ever done, I think this is the most personal of my client projects. So An-Nahar newspaper is the largest newspaper in Lebanon, and in 2005, their chief editor was assassinated by a car bomb. One of the top journalists was also assassinated that year, and it was a very, very dark period for Lebanon. It was full of political assassinations, and I went to Lebanon and I presented the concept, and it was based on just one sentence. That's what I had presented to them. It's called Yajabal Mayhiz Zakriyah, which means the mountain that will not be shaken by the wind. And that was the concept for the newspaper, that they are going to stay, they will not be intimidated, they are there, they are forceful, they will not be shaken. And that kind of statement made itself into the design as well. What you can see over here, it's a sculptural approach to the design. When you're looking at the forest, you still see the effect of the hand movement. You still see the effect of the pen and the thicks and the thins and how things are changing. But as you can see over here, but then there's a lot of tension in the curves. There's a lot of discipline in making curves that are very strong, very powerful, but with perfect tension. It's like made of steel and really, really powerful. And that was what it was supposed to do. It was supposed to come out on the newspaper in headlines to just say that we are here. And then when you see it in here, there is no nonsense in this typeface. It's there, and it makes a very, very powerful impact. And when we see it, this was the this was at 3 a.m. in the morning, the first edition of the redesigned newspaper. We were there. It has fingerprints on it because we picked it up right from the press. And then you see the typeface being used, and it has such a dark, powerful presence. And they loved it so much, they gave it the name of the chief editor. So, and that was his daughter. And that's like the nicest compliment that a client can do, that they take on the message of the typeface. When they go out to speak about the redesign, they talk about the new typeface, that is the new voice of the newspaper, and that is the kind of validation that you get as a type designer that is impossible to explain, because usually people do not talk about typefaces. They talk about the redesign, but nobody, barely graphic designers talk about typefaces. So it's amazing when they come in and they say, this is us, and this is us speaking, and it's just an amazing, amazing experience. And but given all of this, I mean, we did the redesign, but it just does not seem to help. And so sometimes you get this unfortunate reality of like, okay, so what's the point of good typography if the reality sucks? Everything that we try to do to make things look better, but then the reality still sucks. So what do you design for? Why would you design? And I think after a lot of soul searching, I think we always need to keep in mind that typography cannot be divorced from the reality it lives in. It is part of our visual culture, it's part of the collective visual memory that we have. And so if we cannot divorce it from the reality, then maybe if we're not designing for today, then maybe we design for tomorrow. And so we need to look forward, because that's how it is. We cannot really have a fulfilling life if we do not look at ourselves as citizens first, and then designers next. So I'm very much for, you know, design activism, and for being part of the communities that we live in, and building part of that. And so that is life as well. And it's amazing to see typefaces come alive. And they did here in Melbourne. So this is at the library. This is little me. my letters are bigger than me. So this is quite cool. And so I don't know if you guys have seen it before. We opened it on Monday. And if you have time, it would be nice for you to go see it. And I hope you enjoyed the presentation. And if you have any questions, I'm at the conference. Please come up and talk to me. And thank you all. Thank you.